I'm sure a lot of you guys know that I have been friends with Blair White for a while. I mean, I never really got to know her that well, but I think it's about time that I officially separate myself from her online. There's just a lot of things that I've been seeing that she's been doing, and I feel so uncomfortable making this video because I know she was a friend, but like, she is many times over said things that are transphobic, that are racist. I mean, Blair White, why doesn't it be Blair White? Honestly though, like, that is racist as hell, and her tits are fake, her extensions look like shit. I cannot associate myself with this person anymore. I'm just done. I'm sick of it. I hate her.
I'm canceling this video.
So this video is a rant on cancel culture.
Where do I look? Sorry.
Wait, what? Into the lens.
Okay, probably the lens, right in the center.
So this video is on cancel culture. I'm sure a lot of you have heard of the ridiculous drama with James Charles and Tati and who else?
Tati?
Jeffree Star. Tati? Is that what we're saying now? Is she canceled?
Oh God.
She tried to cancel and then she was canceled. Yeah, so if you guys are not familiar with cancel culture, I kind of want to come up with some kind of a definition for it. It's just like hopping on a bandwagon of hating someone without any evidence that they are even guilty of what they're doing, or the thing that they did is like some tweet from 5 years ago that has been dug up and now is going to ruin their career.
It's so toxic. I know for me, I've dealt with, I mean, it's funny because you brought up like the blackface in the beginning, but like people really do bring up this picture of me wearing a face mask, which is like for pores. I think it's literally for blackheads. That somehow is evidence that I did blackface, which why would you ever be stupid enough to post blackface intentionally?
I mean, clearly it's a face mask.
Yeah.
I don't understand. At that point, people are digging and they're searching and they're trying to find some reason to come for you, because people like, I feel like watching
People fail.
More like, they like watching people build themselves up, but even more than that, watching that whole thing collapse underneath them.
Yeah.
It's just like, yes!
There's a very scary, like, mob mentality, basically. Yeah. Whereas, like, for me, I remember when, in particular, the James Charles stuff was happening. I've never been the biggest fan of James Charles. I know people around LA who say he's not a great person, and I do trust their opinion, so he's probably not a great person. But I thought it was really, really gross. I've never personally seen so many millions of people taking enjoyment and getting fulfillment out of watching someone's life be ruined. I mean, clearly he's bounced back now, but at the time it was looking like his life was over. I mean,
yeah.
If you get accusations of sexual misconduct, it's like, that's it, girl. But for him, you know, it was scary watching so many. I mean, I think the Social Blade website even crashed because so many people were just checking
what
on his downfall.
Like 3 million he lost, right?
I think it was like a little more than that.
Oh my God.
It was crazy.
I can't even imagine having 3 million.
No, I know, I was just saying, like, he lost like 5 of our entire careers.
I remember thinking the whole thing was kind of sketchy because her rant on him was 90% about how she felt betrayed because he promoted a product other than her own. And then she like threw in a little sexual assault, and I made a video on it, and I'm like, it just seems sketchy to me, and people hated me for it. They're like, okay, now you're canceled.
Yeah, it's crazy because if he really had that much of an issue with someone being a sexual predator, why would it take them promoting a vitamin for you to say it? You know what I mean? So I thought that was really, really stupid.
Yeah, that's like, so had he promoted her product, she would have never outed him for the sexual assault.
He caught her in a lie because he posted clips where he promoted it like 3 times.
So she flat out lied in a lot of these things, and with an accusation as serious as sexual assault, to me it just blows my mind that people are, it's just, you're guilty. Like, there is no trial, there is no, you know, expectation of evidence at all. It's just, I heard so-and-so say this, I'm a fan of them, or I don't know, they seem trustworthy enough, therefore you are guilty of these things they accused you of.
That's like a life-shattering act. It's not like, oh, you promoted a vitamin, or oh, you lied in your video, or oh, that post was insensitive. It's like, sexual assault and sexual misconduct is something people take very seriously, which they should. But there's this weird thing I've always been, it's been one of my principles, that you never just blindly believe every accusation. You treat it seriously and you definitely follow up on it, and you definitely support the person, whoever they are, making that accusation. But you have to understand that when you just blindly believe it, there is a person on the other end whose life is potentially shattered, just ruined.
Yeah, I mean, and it's funny because like what we do online is like social commentators of sorts, I guess. We get both ends of it because what if you say something that somebody doesn't like? Then you're canceled. Like, I'm sure like many more times throughout our internet career we'll be canceled for some reason or another. But also, I get accused all the time for participating in this, which I mean, I think we're all a little guilty of to a degree.
I personally caught myself looking at James Ross's social blade. I wasn't really coming for him like that, but it made me sick though that it really is this weird mob mentality and I participated in it. So.
Yeah, I agree. And I feel bad for like, it's hard because whenever you are online and you see something of this magnitude happen, it's difficult to step back. Because you're like, oh my God, this is monumental. This has never happened before to this degree. That's crazy. So you kind of watch it happen as a spectator. But at the same time, like there's a difference I feel like between someone going through something like that. And then now I'm at this place where it's, are you afraid to then ever call anybody out for anything?
Oh yeah, yeah. I think there needs to be a shift from cancel culture to just accountability culture. And not accountability for something innocuous and minor someone said 5 years ago. I'm talking like things they actually do. Because a good example is, what's the guy who's recently going down for the pedo stuff? Bella, no. What's the name of the guy who-
Austin Jones.
Yeah. That's a good example of someone who probably deserves to be canceled.
Yeah, that's not cancel culture at all because
that's accountability.
All of the outrage around him was all justified.
Yeah.
And he's convicted legally of the things he was accused of and is now going to jail.
That's different.
Yeah, so I do feel like, you know, there are things that deserve a certain amount of backlash. Like he deserves-
When they're proven.
Yeah, he deserves what happened to him. So I'm not saying that it's bad to ever hold someone accountable for the things that they have done wrong, but if there's something that someone just throws out, some baseless accusation, especially something as serious as sexual assault or sexual misconduct, I really do feel like people need to like take a breath and wait before just being like, you are absolutely guilty, I'm unsubscribing, oh my God, I'm gonna contact all of your sponsors and try to have your entire career ruined, your income is just gonna be demolished, I'm gonna reach out to your landlord and try to get you evicted, I'm going to find your family and try to like bring them into this.
I dealt with that too.
Yeah, it's insane, people don't know where to stop.
Just on a deep level, a lot of people, I would say most people in the world are unhappy with their life.
Mm-hmm.
And seeing,
Bella, be quiet, please.
And seeing success, especially to the magnitude of, and this is just an example, this video isn't about James Charles, but James Charles' success is like nothing social media has ever seen before. He's at the Met Gala, he is on morning talk shows, he is in magazines and places that would never publicize Jeffree Star. And so to me, it seems just personally, my opinion, my conspiracy allegedly, that that was sort of a source of that because Jeffree promised up and down he was going to post receipts about how James Charles is a predator and the world will know, and then he didn't.
Yeah, I saw his video where he's like, I'm done. I don't want to be a part of this anymore.
Yeah.
Like after you just wrecked someone's career and now-
No one else will get away with it.
And now the spotlight is on you. You're like, I just don't want to participate. It's like, well, you're already in it.
You're
in
it.
It's too late. It's too late to back out.
It'd be like if I was like, I'm going to post receipts. And this is someone who's hated, like Onision. If I promised-
Someone who needs to fucking be canceled.
Someone who should be canceled is an
idiot. You're, by the way, you're a bitch.
Why do they keep calling me a bitch?
I don't know. You just are. You just really, really are.
I don't get it.
Blair White, I think she's kind of just a bitch. You know? Just through and through, I think she's just a bitch.
I mean, I know I'm a bitch. What's up? The thing about it is like, that would be like me promising on Twitter, I'm like, I'm gonna post receipts that will show the world finally that Onision is a sexual predator, all these things. And then if I come on YouTube and I'm like, this has been enough. We have to stop.
I can't talk about it anymore.
And that's even someone who's very, very hated.
Yeah.
And I would honestly probably get away with it just based on how hated he is, but that wouldn't make it right.
No, you know what absolutely I mean? Not.
You can't do that.
There's nothing more to Blair White other than she's kind of just a fucking bitch.
That man has called me so many damn names, like...
Do you remember that one video I made?
The compilation?
And I made a compilation of him calling you. It was like a cunt. It was so many different times.
I couldn't even believe it.
Dumbass motherfucker. Fucking pieces of shit. Worthless human beings. Dumb cunt. Brain dead bitch. Dumb bitch. Idiot fuck stain. Dumb cunt. Dumb bimbo. Dumb fucking lying cunt. Bitch. Fuckface. Dumb fucking useless bitch. Before running your dumb cunt mouth. You keyboard warrior piece of shit. You dumb fuck. And this brain dead fuck. Useless fucking dumb piece of shit cunt. Shit stain. Dishonest cunt. Fuckface. Let's continue, you fuck.
That's
he really hates you. And the only reason that he hates you so much is because the debate, I do this for the debate I had with him too, you completely like annihilated him.
And I have fake boobs. He hates that.
Our flashback first picture, to our picture. Tits out for Onision.
Yes, bitch. Yeah, it's very easy to cancel public people because all their mistakes and their successes are public. But I know if you're watching this, you have said something in your life, in private, or even just amongst your friends and family, that if that were a tweet or if that were a video,
oh my God.
Like, everyone's
getting
canceled.
Could you imagine?
Yeah.
Like, there was that story of the girl who she got on a plane, and when she landed, a tweet that she had posted went viral and it ruined her life. Like,
oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, there's so many, and there's a whole TED talk on it. Like, it was a huge thing. So it's anybody, even if you're not someone that's a public figure, you can still be canceled. You can still be a victim of this, like, outrage that's disproportionate to what someone actually deserves.
I feel like more than ever, like, empathy is gone. Like, people, like mm-hmm. I said, they make one mistake and it's like one strike, you're out. No forgiveness. You can't learn from it. But even if you do learn from it, we don't care.
Yeah.
And that is really toxic. And that honestly does breed a lot of anxiety within me sometimes, because obviously almost everything I do is public. And so I'm like,
oh yeah, I'm totally walking on eggshells. Like, I'm still outspoken, but it's in my head. Like, oh God, what if this thing that I say is edited out of context? And, you know, me making fun of you at the beginning of this video saying that you're canceled, someone's going to take that and be like, look at Jacqueline Glennon, right, fighting.
Oh yeah, you're definitely going to get, like, within the first few seconds, people are going to watch it and then leave hate comments, not watching the rest of it, I guarantee you.
We'll see you in the comments. I don't know, people never look at intent, and that's what I always say, like, look at what someone's intention is. Are they really trying to be bigoted? Are they really homophobic? Are they really racist? Like, before you throw out these accusations and cancel someone, like, kind of consider the context a little.
Can context? People do? What
is that? Oh, anyway, so this was a rant on cancel culture, because it's been so rampant recently, and we both hate it. So I'm not canceling Blair. I actually would love for you guys to go to her channel, check it out, subscribe to her. She's amazing.
Subscribe to me, or I'll beat you up.
Oh my God. I can't believe that you're threatening people. All right, loves. Thanks for watching, and we will see you later.
Bye, guys. Bye.